and welcome to my seventh video in the series about microorganisms and health. And today we're going to be talking about antibiotics and antibiotic resistance. So the first thing to establish is what antibiotics actually do. They're chemicals which usually, in the case of penicillin, can actually punch holes in the walls, in the cell walls of bacteria. And this is something that's very important about antibiotics, is the fact that they're ineffective against viruses. They only have an effect on bacteria and some fungi. By punching holes in the cell wall, this obviously causes stuff like osmotic lysis, stuff to leach out of the inside of the cell, and therefore the cell can't reproduce. Other types of antibiotics work in other ways, by stopping reproduction and therefore slowing down the growth rate, particularly of bacteria. Without modern antibiotics, it would be safe to assume that most people listening to this video wouldn't be here, because some of your relatives would have died from infections. They were able to treat a number of different diseases very, very effectively. The problem that's been produced is the fact that by overuse and by overprescription and then by incorrect use, we've actually ended up improving the bacteria we're actually trying to kill. And it can work in these several ways. One way to produce resistant strains of bacteria is to actually simply take antibiotics. You can pretty much guarantee by taking antibiotics you're going to end up with resistant strains. The general course of action is when bacteria are able to reproduce, some of those will mutate, and some of those mutations may potentially lead to drug resistance. By taking the drugs, you actively promote the ones that are resistant to survive. And so if the only ones that are able to survive are the drug resistant ones, then the next time they go to reproduce, they'll pass that gene on to the next generation, and therefore they'll then thrive. So when you want to take another antibiotic in the future for a certain infection, then it will be ineffective against that bacteria because it has drug resistance. Now, another way to produce antibiotic resistant bacteria is to take an antibiotic again for a different condition. And what the antibiotic may do is it may wipe out a number of the pretty much beneficial bacteria that you have living within your system. And what this may do is this may promote the survival of the resistant bacteria because of lack of competition. If there's no normal bacteria there that are not resistant, then they're not able to compete for food sources with the resistant strains. So less normal or non-resistant bacteria there are, the better the survival chances of the resistant bacteria, and therefore their numbers can increase and can cause problems within a person. Another way to promote resistance is this method by which bacteria can use to swap genetic information between the same species of bacteria and between different species of bacteria. They do it via this organelle here called a plasmid, and a plasmid is basically a circular piece of DNA, and on these circular pieces of DNA they can carry genes for resistance, and it's very, very possible that these plasmids can exchange between different bacteria and they can exchange resistance, and therefore a species or a type of bacteria that wasn't resistant before, if it comes into contact with a resistant strain, it could possibly gain resistance via these plasmids. Now, part of the problem comes from overprescription of antibiotics, and specifically overprescription for an incorrect diagnosis. You should never give an antibiotic for a viral infection, and also you should use them with caution. For minor infections, it's probably not the best idea to be promoting loads and loads of antibiotics, because you're essentially asking for trouble. You're going to promote the survival of resistant strains. And if it's something that your body could normally clear up itself, then it's probably preferential to do so. One of the most high-profile cases of an antibiotic-resistant bacteria is this bacteria called MRSA, which stands for methicillin-resistant Staph aureus. Staph aureus is the type of bacteria, and methicillin is a type of antibiotic similar to penicillin. And so, because we've been using a great number of different types of antibiotic, it's promoted the survival of this MRSA. And particularly in certain hospitals, and particularly people who are already frail and have an impaired immunity, MRSA can be lethal. So in summary, antibiotics can work by rupturing the cell walls of bacteria or stopping them reproducing. The antibiotic resistance can develop when antibiotics are not used properly. and they'll aid the promotion of resistant strains. Part of the problem comes from overprescription and incorrect prescription of antibiotics. So in order to reduce this, we need to use less and we need to use it sparingly. Only for the very conditions that actually require it should it be prescribed.